zoom the cameras right.
Okay.
And then he said there were some somewhere that like move around. Okay, I don't know where they were.
Good deal for a while, because I'm looking at these and I'm like, these are like $400.
Welcome. Kind of. This is a new one for me, too, and as I'm sure it's new for most of you, I don't even know exactly where the cameras are to be looking at them so that you can feel like I'm talking to you. But I just want to thank you, whether you are viewing this live or later after it's been recorded and posted, I just want you to thank you for taking the time to spend a half an hour or so with us. I feel like this is such a great and wonderful opportunity. It was really difficult for me and for a lot of the students in the spring when we weren't allowed to do this. So I'm grateful that we have the opportunity to be able to sing for other people, even if they're not physically present. I think that's been like a major theme that has been just running around life over the last little while, is that, you know, we can still find ways to communicate, we can still find ways to be with each other and to reach out and touch other people, even if it can't be 100% in person. With that, I kind of selected music for this concert. I don't usually theme my concerts too much, and there isn't necessarily a theme with this, but as I looked for music for these groups, I wanted to find music that I thought would be easy for them to communicate, and would be easy for them to attach to, and would be easy for them to help you. Because I anticipated that something like this was probably likely. That would be easy for them to help you feel like you were here with us. So that is my hope for tonight, is that as we are not together, we can still kind of be together. And that hopefully there's somebody out there who's listening to and watching this that we can help, that we can touch. Hopefully make your day a little better through the gift of our music. So this is Coro Voce, our premier women's choir. They will be singing four numbers for you: Quando Sperai by Claudio Monteverdi, the Kong Ding Flower Song, arranged by Victor Johnson, and De Colores, arranged by somebody whose name has just left my mind because it's sitting over there on the piano, and Safe and Sound, originally performed by Taylor Swift in the Civil Wars, as arranged by Mark Breimer. Yeah, for the students sitting around here, in case it wasn't obvious already, like, you can still pretend like you're an audience and clap and stuff. That's fine. That's kosher.
Thank you. too slow.
Microphone was off that entire time, so that was useful. Well, you know, this microphone isn't the one that matters, it's those two down there that matter, so that's fine. So, while they are coming off, and acapella is coming on, I just really need to give an absolute shout-out to these kids. They're not really kids, they're like blooming adults. And that's a fascinating thing to watch. And choir is not a place where you would necessarily expect to need to all of a sudden take on like huge responsibility. But that has certainly been the case this past quarter, as you see me now running around and playing the piano and doing all sorts of things like that. They've kind of been forced to be a little bit more independent of me than they perhaps have been in the past. And they've just absolutely stepped up to that challenge and have done so much to make what we do still so musical and so beautiful. And I'm just very appreciative of that, that they have that kind of drive and that kind of willingness to just kind of step up to the plate and say, you know what, like, not we don't need you, but like, we can still do it, even if you're not in front of us. So this is Acapella, our large mixed group. They'll be performing three numbers for you today. Ave Verum Corpus by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Thistle and Rose by Phyllis somebody. I should have brought my music up here, and I didn't. And then an arrangement of We Shall Overcome by J. Donald Moore.
Thank you.
So this next piece will feature a crew of soloists at the beginning, and I'm going to see if I can remember all of them. We have Avery Brown, Genesee Reed, Tania Peterson, Kaylee Miller, Anna Thacker, and Christina Vincent. I'm forgetting someone. I feel like I'm forgetting someone. Is that it? No, I think that's it. I think I remembered everybody. Those are our soloists. These in-between moments in the concert where I usually have like some sort of small talk with the audience planned so that it's not awkward to just like watch these people walk off stage and then walk on stage. I don't know that I really have that much to say except they're awesome. So, like, I'm really grateful to work with these students. It is super fabulous. I have people stop me sometimes, like, in grocery stores or, like, when I go on events with the choir students, you know, hotel clerks or things like that. They're like, wait, you're a high school choir teacher? Yeah. And, like, you're okay with that? Yes. Very much so. I feel like people think there has to be something wrong with you to want to work with high schoolers. And I consider that to be like one of the biggest blessings in my life in particular, is that I get to associate with all of these really, really awesome, awesome teenagers that just do so many really incredible, incredible things and teach me an awful lot. So I'm grateful to you for the opportunity that I have to work with your students. Thank you for letting me borrow them for a period every other day, or more often if they have more of my classes than that. So our madrigals, they will sing three songs for you now. First one is an arrangement of Bound for the Promised Land by Anonymous. I have a sneaking suspicion, just because of the way that it's written and because I kind of recognize the handwriting on it, that it may have been arranged by our previous teacher here, Adrian Tawa, but I am not sure of that. But I'll give her credit for it anyway, because I think it was by her. Second piece is Verleidensfrieden by Felix Mendelssohn, and then last, our traditional Cuarongo. One quick note, just because I feel like I have to say it, about this Verleidensfrieden. I discovered this piece in the spring of last year, and I just thought to myself, holy cow, like, that is so beautiful. And I just really wanted the madrigals to do it. And then I came, like, reality hit that if the madrigals sang this piece, I would either have to find somebody to play the piano or I would have to do it, because it's not the world's, like, nicest, you know, greatest, easiest piano parts to play in the entire world. Well, I'm lazy and I didn't find anybody, so it's me playing it. So you can ignore me and listen to the beautifulness that comes from them, because that's really the point on this one. So, Bound for the Promised Land, Verleidensfrieden, and Cuarongo.
Sorrow, pain, and death are felt and feared no more. I am
Again, thank you for joining us tonight, whether you have been following along real time with the live stream or whether you watch this later on. I appreciate and love the opportunity we have to make music and to share it with you. So I hope you have an absolutely fabulous evening. Good night. Da-da-da-da-da.